Hey guys, I'm Harmony. If you didn't know, well now you know. Welcome to my YouTube channel. For today's video, I actually have a collaboration for you guys. This video is a collaboration with It's Naima Stackhouse. Hopefully I said that right. I'm pretty sure I said that right. She sent me a voice recording of how to pronounce it, so I think I got it right. For today's video, me and her are going to be giving you 10 apps that you need, you absolutely need, as a small YouTuber. We're actually going to be doing 9 different apps altogether because one of our apps are the same. That's because me and her basically use the same apps, but like I have to keep it different, you know? Before I get started, make sure you smash that like button, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you have not already, and hit that notification bell right beside it so you'll be notified every single time I upload. And yeah, let's get started. So the first app that you need as a small YouTuber is, of course, YouTube Studio. YouTube Studio is used to check your YouTube analytics. I use it sometimes to reply to comments, especially if I'm on the go and I get a notification that I got a comment, then maybe I'll reply really, really quick on my phone, especially if my computer is not accessible to me, because usually, like I told you guys many, many times, I wait 2 to 3 days to reply to your guys' comments. If I do reply to your comment as soon as I post the video, that is because it's on my phone, just to let you guys know. So yes, you can check your analytics on here. You can see your sub count, your watch time, your views, your subscriber change, all of that. You can also use YouTube Studio to add your thumbnails. If you guys want, I will do a tutorial on how to do this, but before you add thumbnails to your video, you must verify your Gmail account through YouTube Studio, or else it won't let you upload the thumbnail that you want. So if your account is not verified, it will just have video clips. If your account is not verified, it will just have video clips all in here, and it will be different sections from the video, and it won't let you pick the actual thumbnail that you want. So YouTube Studio is really, really important. I feel like every small YouTuber has it, but I'm just letting you guys know that it is a great app, especially if you need to add a thumbnail. The next app is Velo. Now this is the app that me and her have the same because we both use Velo as our primary editor. Velo is a great, great, great editing app, especially for beginners. I know a lot of people use iMovie because that's just what is there for them. That's what's accessible. iMovie already comes on their device, so why would they download another device just to edit, you know? It will save less storage. But Velo is great because it's really, really simple once you get the hang of it. I had to learn from scratch. I'm actually a fast learner, so it didn't take me too long to learn how to use this app. I will say a lot of the stuff on here you have to pay for. That's why I sometimes use CapCut, but now that I'm editing on my MacBook, I don't know how I'm going to be using CapCut to edit because I'm not gonna be having my clips go to my phone anymore, so I'm not sure how that would work. But CapCut is great as well. It's not one of the apps that I have on here, but just saying, CapCut is great because it has a lot of stuff that you don't have to pay for. I really don't think you have to pay for anything on there. Just like, of course, every app has like a premium or a pro feature or whatever. But CapCut is great because if I want to add like a video overlay, I can't do that on Velo. I can only add a photo overlay, which really, really sucks because I wish I could do it on Velo, but you know, I can't. But yes, other than that, Velo is a great editor and I don't see myself using any other editor. I already know Velo so much and it's really easy for me. The next one you need as a small YouTuber is some form of social media. I know some people's parents out here, they're a little bit strict and blah, 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 but social media is important, especially when you are trying to build a foundation or a career on YouTube. How are you gonna build a foundation on YouTube and not have any other form of social media? Even a Gmail is fine. I know Yazzie Carter, my YouTube friend, y'all should know her by now. I don't think she has social media, but me and her contact through via email. So if you just have email, that's great. I have Snapchat, Instagram, Pinterest, all of that. I have like all the social media, so it's really important for me to have social media because if I want to do collaborations or sponsorships and any of that, I'll need to contact people. If you guys want to get in contact with me, my socials are always in my description. If you guys are looking to do a collaboration or a sponsorship, I would recommend you have a business email because don't put out your actual email that you have on your YouTube account. Just don't do it.
Alrighty, so I'm currently editing. I just wanted to do a little pop-in. Y'all are probably kind of confused. What I meant to say is, don't use that same email that you have underneath your YouTube channel. I hope that makes sense. Don't use the same email that you have for your YouTube channel account. Use a separate one.
So make a business email personally for your YouTube channel so you can get in contact with brands and other small YouTubers. You know, that's gonna help you build off a foundation and that's gonna help you succeed within your YouTube channel. The next one I have is Lightroom. Lightroom is really, really great. I use it to enhance the photos. You know, my thumbnail pictures be looking a little dry and crusty, so I use Lightroom to like touch it up a little bit and change the lighting and all of that good stuff because I want my thumbnails to be eye-catching and I can't do that unless I have Lightroom. Lightroom is really, really great. I made 2 presets on there. Presets are basically just like a safe style, you know, so you can have a certain amount of lighting, a certain amount of detail, a certain amount of color added to the photo, and you can save that style. And if you want to use it again, you know, just press the preset. I did a tutorial on it on how I make my thumbnails, but yes. And the last app I have is MP3 Converter. I need to hurry up because my camera battery is flashing at me and I don't want to die. I don't want it to die. I swear, I cannot talk today and I do not know what is wrong with me. But yes, the last app is MP3 Converter. I haven't heard of like any other YouTubers use this app, but it is a great app. That is how I get all my music. So basically what I do is I screen record music from YouTube or Thematic, and then I go into MP3 Converter and I convert it, so then it just saves as an audio, and then I can open that audio in Velo. And I'll just put out my video. If you guys want to see a tutorial on that, I can definitely do that because it's really simple and easy. And I feel like MP3 Converter is really, really underrated because I haven't heard of anybody else use it so far. But it's a great app, to be honest. Like, it's a really great app. Yeah, I'll probably do a tutorial anyways, whether you guys like it or not, because, you know, it's a great app. So why not push some more content out for you guys? That is all the apps that I have for you guys today. Thank you so much for Naima for reaching out to me and asking if we can collaborate. I really, really love your channel. And you are a baddie, period. And keep doing what you're doing because your YouTube channel is bomb. If you guys enjoyed, make sure you smack that like button, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and hit that notification bell right beside it so you'll be notified every single time I upload. I'm talking a little too fast, but I'll see you in my next video. Bye! Oh my God, you fell.